If you have a DC refrigerator in your camper van, you're going to need to know how to wire it to a fuse block. And that's exactly what we're going to cover today in lesson number 5 of this Branch Circuits playlist. My name is Nate and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, before we get started, there's a couple prerequisite pieces of information you need to know, like cutting wire, stripping wire, crimping terminals into wire, but we've already covered that in a specific playlist of this academy, so go back and review that if you don't already know how to do this part. And lastly, before we get started, the fuse block that we're using in this particular demo is the Blue Sea Blade Fuse Block. Now, there's several different types of fuse blocks on the market, like the Progressive Dynamics Fuse Block, the Blue Sea Safety Hub, the Tiger Expedition UFO 200, and all of those are realistically going to be connected in much the same way. They're all getting their power from a different distribution hub, like the Victron Lynx distributor, which is getting its power from the battery. But we're going to skip all of that side of the system and focus mainly on how we get power to the rest of the branch circuit. Let's get started. Most DC refrigerators are the same. This is an ICECO refrigerator. ARB refrigerators are pretty much the same. I think I'm blanking on all the different brands of refrigerators, but like I said, they're all pretty much the same, and they all generally come with their own power wire. So to connect the power wire to the fuse block, it's pretty straightforward. The hardest part is trying to figure out which is the positive and which is the negative. This came out of Grace's truck, so it was already wired, so she already figured out which was positive and which was negative. But in order to do that, she just looked right here at the side of the port where the wire connects, and there is a positive and negative little icon right next to each of the terminals there. And once you get that plugged in, it only goes in there one direction. And so then you can look at the positive one, and then this particular wire has two wires, you know, side by side, it's duplex wiring. And it's sort of easy to just follow those all the way to the end. I'm noticing on this one, the positive wire is the smoother wire. The negative terminal down there has got these sort of ridges on this wire. So I'm just going to follow that to the end, and the ridges down here, got that on the negative wire. The smoother wire, positive wire. So to connect this, you can just plug it in right here, run the wire over to the fuse block, and I'll assume that the wire is long enough to connect. Connect it to the fuse block. Just like so, with the positive wire going to the positive terminal of the fuse block, negative wire going to the negative terminal of the fuse block. And then that's pretty much good to go, and we can go ahead and put our fuse in place. And we can see it turns on. Now this particular fridge, and I would say most fridges on the market, they do have a on-off button just right on them that we can turn the refrigerator on or off. But if you stumbled across one that doesn't, I haven't seen one, but maybe they're out there, you can put a switch on the positive wire. You just cut this positive wire, put spade connectors on it, and then a simple DC rated toggle switch right on those spade connectors, and then you can mount this wherever you need to. Now, if this wire is not long enough, which sometimes could be the case, you can make some extension wires. 10 gauge is usually a good size for this. And you would just, you know, extend your wires here. You'd crimp a ring terminal on one side, and then a lever nut on the other side. Goes in there right there like that. And then you could, oops. Just like that. And then this wire, you know, you would just cut and then strip off the insulation and put it into this lever nut to extend that wire. And that's really all there is to it. There's really not a lot to this, and I'm not going to over explain it because it's pretty straightforward, I do believe, but that is how that works. So in the next video, we're going to cover relays. So we'll click up here to watch, and we'll see you over there.